The next play that we're gonna go over is the PF screen post. This is a very, very quick hit play, but it has tons of options. Here, it just seems like the point guard dribbles from the right side of the elbow to the left side of the elbow, tries to hit the shooting guard in the corner if he's open, and then if he's not open, he tries to hit the power forward. So let's just stick with the basic play right now and look at the principles and see what we can do from there. Okay, the initial play, come here, check for the screen. He was slightly open. Okay, actually that should have went in. Let's just check that entire play here. Ben Gordon gets picked. Actually could have used some directional passing here and kept him in the corner. Directional icon passing. Okay. Ben Gordon did not jump at the time of his release, so that's a very good jumper. Richard Hamilton just missed it. That's the initial part of the play. The second part of the play is to try to hit the power forward as he comes off of this screen. And this is basically an isolation. And that's exactly what happened. Now, I caught them off guard in transition. And that's why we had Kirk Heinrich on him. But the pick worked there. We could have given it to Richard Hamilton there. But the second part of the play is the isolation. No one moves on the court. Okay, now Rasheed's like, man, give him the ball. But trying to explain the play, Rasheed, chill out, man. Okay, just a quick isolation, quick back down. Okay, could have backed down Tyrus Thomas too. Nice post move, nothing but bucket. Now running the same play. Watch this here. Richard Hamilton's not open. But Rasheed is. Yeah. Now see, that's just another part of the fade. Yeah, we didn't go to the right side or the left side of the court there. Okay, the replay didn't go far enough. Richard Hamilton did not get hit by the pick. Antonio McDice, we didn't give it to him. He didn't, what if he didn't roll right, or he wasn't open for the roll? Or what if there's a strong defender on him? What if someone like Tim Duncan is on McDice, but Alberto is on Rasheed? So then we just whip the ball here. The play doesn't break down. It's still an isolation. Okay, nobody moves. Rasheed backs him down. I actually could have just stood out of here and busted him from back there. Rasheed's such a good shooter. But we'd use a nice low post move. Looks like it's about to get blocked, but it's Rasheed. He never gets blocked. His release is so freaking high. And it's an and one. Okay, that's just from the basic part of the play. All right, working with another part of this play here, we can actually call for a pick by Antonio McDice. If nothing opens or breaks down, and then, you know, he does that. Nocioni gets a block on Antonio McDice. But let's just check this out. Okay, the screen doesn't work for Richard Hamilton off jump. Okay, yeah, at one point we go to Antonio McDice, we could have here. At another point, we went to Tayshaun Prince, to Rasheed. But this time, we call for a pick for Antonio McDice. All you have to do is hold the LB button, or the L1 button, and then hit B. And it calls for a pick to the closest post defender, or the post player. And then you just set he sets a nice pick. We get the mismatch that we want. Nice pass. Should have been a dunk, but it wasn't. And he hit the bottom of the rim. Now also remember that you don't have to do it on this side with this player. We could have actually passed it to Tayshaun Prince and done a pick and roll with Rasheed and Tayshaun Prince. Also, another option on this play is to just give it to Tayshaun Prince and let him isolate versus a smaller or a shorter player or a less powerful player, since, well, Tayshaun isn't very powerful. But, you know, you see what I'm saying. Tayshaun's long, he's big, and if he doesn't have a guy like Luol Deng on him, just say he has Danielle Wright from the Miami Heat, he can just take that guy to the hole or post him up or do whatever. So there are plenty of options on this very, very simple play that you can go over. Okay, this last play here is called Baluba Screen. This is probably the easiest play in the game, but it has so many options, just like the last one. All it is the two front court players, the power forward and the center, are setting two down screens for the shooting guard and the small forward. Now, let's aim for the shooting guard first, since he is making a V-cut here. He's coming down, setting his man up, and making a V-cut towards the elbow area. Okay, let's just check that out there. That was a beautiful play, beautiful release. And remember, this is the same play that I was using in, or actually not the same play, but this was the same type of setup, same type of screen and V-cut that I was using in the directional icon passing part where Rudy Gay would get it at different parts of the court. Okay, so you can actually make Luol Deng get a hit by this screen here if I could have directionally passed it and made Richard Hamilton stay over here somewhere. But just following the play here, he gets the ball. And also remember what I said earlier about that you don't have to be, the defender doesn't have to be a foot, 2 foot, 3 feet away. All the defender has to is not be able to put a hand up or jump when you shoot the ball. And if that's the case, your player is open and he has a good shot. Richard Hamilton jumps. Luol Deng is very late. And the result is, I got nothing but splash, baby. Okay, this time we're concentrating on Tayshaun Prince. Wow. Okay. Now, for all of you that may be thinking that it's not, this is on Hall of Fame mode. You know me, I'm always on the most difficult mode. As you see, I make a lot of things more difficult for myself. I love challenges. The free throw difficulty is up to 75. In my associations is up to 80, 85. But, you know, these shots are going in because of the way the play is being set up and the way the play is being ran. Okay, the same thing happens on the right side with Richard Hamilton. Okay, actually, we could have gone to rip. That was a nice screen by Antonio McDyess. Okay, Tayshaun Prince doesn't get a huge screen, but he gets separation. Look at that. And once again, I tell you, if the defender is not in position to jump when you jump, you have a good jumper. Okay, Ben Wallace is still on the ground. It's too late. It's too late. And then, of course, the result is whack. Nothing but bucket. Okay? Nothing but bucket. It would have even been prettier if he would got hit by that pick, but he didn't get hit by the pick. And I also used directional passing. Okay? If I just would have pressed the A button, he would have just gotten the ball right here. But I brought him in a little bit more. See him keep running. Took about one or two more steps. Fire, release, bucket. Also, you can set pick and roll play with anybody that you want to get an easier jumper. Now at this point, guys, we've gone over the two basic parts of the play, and here you can just pretty much do whatever you'd like to. You can get a screen here and then throw it to the paint, post up somebody who can do a good job of posting up. That was a great block by Ben Wallace. That happens, especially on Hall of Fame. Okay, now I caught him in transition and had a mismatch, Luol Deng versus Rasheed Wallace. And I did just a normal spin move here. Ben Wallace did rotate well. The best thing that I could have done is to kick it out to Richard Hamilton, but didn't. Went for the dunk, he got blocked. But your options are endless on this play. Just a nice little, the screen there, the two screens at the very beginning of the play. Get your guys initially open. If that doesn't work, you can run a pick and roll with either of the guards or your backcourt players. You can run a pick and roll with your point guard and one of the post players. You can feed it into the post. That play is a very good one. So just experiment with that and see what you like and see what you don't like. And then, you know, just get used to running the play.